Hello! Welcome to part 2 of Sable Island. I hope you enjoyed the first one. If you haven't watched it already, go back on my channel and watch Sable Island part 1, because this stuff might not make very much sense if you haven't watched the first one. Anywho, as you can see, I am somewhere new. I'm back at university, so there's not going to be really much for me to vlog, at least in the near future. But who knows, maybe I'll do something exciting again and I'll vlog again. But anyway, this will be it for at least a while, so I hope you enjoy Sable Island Part 2. Also, if you notice in the last one, I've been on a bit of a John Mayer streak with the vlogs, and that's going to happen again in this video. Sorry if you don't like John Mayer, but that's what I was listening to a lot while I was at Sable Island, and it just seems to suit the vibe, so more John Mayer to come, but hope you enjoy. Morning. I think this is day 9 of field work. I think that might be right. Anyway, I'm losing track of the days. It's actually Sunday though. I didn't get any footage yesterday because we didn't go out in the field. It was raining quite a lot and most of our field work has to do with cameras. So we obviously couldn't do our field work yesterday. But today I am in the field again. I am sitting with this band of 5. There's a little foal and all you can see is his little ears in the grass. Are you hiding, Mr. Foal? Hello! Being a foal is very hard work. Requires lots of napping. Hello. It's hard work. Yeah, being a foal is exhausting. Hello. So the last day I was out, I showed you guys my notebook and what I did when I surveyed each horse, but I only got single bachelors that day, so I couldn't really show you all that much. So today I'll show you this band of 5 that I'm watching right now. I'll show you what I wrote down in my notebook for them. So this is my band of 5, and I'll try to say like the mum of the foal, and you just kind of have to wait to make sure that they suckle, and if you see them suckling then you can write down which horse is the foal. Foal's mom. In this case, this is H4, so mom of H3.
Who says I can't get stoned? Turn off the lights and the telephone. Me in my house alone. Who says I can't get stoned? Who says I can't be free from all of the things that I used to be? Rewrite my history. Who says I can't be free? It's been a long night in New York City. It's been a long night in Baton Rouge. I don't remember you looking any better. But then again, I don't remember you.
Hello. I'm currently trekking around to see if I can find another band of horses to survey. I thought I'd let you guys know that I was listening to a BBC podcast about the evolution of horses. It was very cool. Thank you, David, for recommending that. I will tell you one thing that is new information to me. We used to milk horses, and I had no idea that that was ever a thing, like cows. Anyway, thought that was cool.
Who says I can't get stoned? Call up a girl that I used to know. Fake love for an hour, so who says I can't get stoned? Who says I can't take time? Meet all the girls on the county line. Wait on fate to send a sign. Who says I can't take time? It's been a long night in New York City. It's been a long night in Austin too.
don't remember you looking any better. But then again, I don't remember you.
Good morning. It is day 10 of field work. I'm up a little bit earlier this morning so that I can do my lab routine. It gets swapped off between person and person, so today is my day to do the morning lab routine. I'll show you a couple snippets.
It's been a long night in New York City. It's been a long night in Baton Rouge. Don't remember you looking any better. But then again, I don't remember you. Who says I can't get stoned? Call up a girl that I used to know. Fake love for an hour, so who says I can't get stoned? Who says I can't take time? Meet all the girls in the county line. Wait on fate to send a sign. Who says I can't take time? It's been a long night in New York City. It's been a long night in Austin too. I don't remember you looking any better. Says I can't get stoned. It's been a long night in New York City. It's been a long time since 22. I don't remember you looking any better. But then again, I don't remember you.
I'm just sitting here with a group of two bachelors. Not too much to do. We're just finishing up a section for the day, and that'll be about it. Today I haven't really listened to any podcasts, although I have been listening to country music, which I think suits the vibe, as well as I've been listening to a lot of John Mayer in the last few days, and I feel like both are kind of good Sable Island vibes. Anywho, I'm just sitting here. I thought maybe I'd show you what I wear in the field, because I'm bored and I don't really know what else to show you guys, so I'm going to show you that. So these are my hiking boots. They're Vast hiking boots. I brought them brand new before I got here because I've never owned a pair of hiking boots in my life. These are my gaiters. They're waterproof. They keep the sand from going in the tops of my boots. And I'm wearing my hiking pants. I'm gonna get up to show you the rest because it's too hard to do this sitting down. Okie dokie, now I'm standing up, so I'm gonna show you my pants. Borrowed hiking pants. Not gonna lie, they slide down a lot. So I have my belt on plus my fanny pack in my belt loops to keep them from falling down, but that's what we got, and you know what, they're working pretty well. I've got a long sleeve shirt on. Out here it's like so sunny and the UV rays are really concentrated here, so you have to wear long sleeves. As well, I always wear a hat because it's really, really sunny all the time. most of the time, and then if it's really sunny, I wear my big hat. Anyway, that's what I wear in the field. In my fanny pack, I have my little GoPro in case I want to take some videos, my phone, my field notebook, a couple pencils. But anyway, I was bored, so I thought I'd show you guys what I wear in the field. Yeah, that's that. Field work. We are out again at the very east tip of the island, and I thought I'd show you that. I don't really know that you can see it, but like right there, it's the east tip of the island. As well, behind me is that lighthouse there. That's the east light. Very creative. Anyway, I'm standing on this very high ridge, and I've hiked up and down these ridges a lot because every once in a while there's like a big drop. So you have to hike down and then hike back up and then go along top and then hike back down and go up and then hike along top. I'm exhausted. It's like 11:30. I saw this chestnut earlier with this really big blaze and really like high stockings, and he was really cute. But yeah, now I'm just searching for more ponies for a while. Oh, and in case you're wondering, I am listening to my 2000s playlist. So, that's the east tip there, and east light. What is it? Braver. Wow, so brave. Can I come look at it too? You're not very sure of it. Hello. Again, waiting for poops from a band of seven. I thought, since I've been saying that I pick up poops from the horses, that I should maybe say why I'm doing that. The reason we're taking fecal samples from the horses is one of the PhD students on the project is working on figuring out what kind of bacteria is living in the horses. So part of the fecal sample goes to that. Another part of the fecal sample is used to find out what parasites are in the horses. So we take some and look for parasite eggs, as well as put some in cups, let them sit for 6 days, and then collect the larva from it. So there's three different reasons why we collect the fecal sample, and I figured, since I'm always saying that I'm sitting waiting for poop from the horses, I should probably tell you what we're doing with the poop. So that's one part of the project. The other part of the project is kind of figuring out like the social community that the horses have. So the different bands, the different sizes of the bands, where they're located, as well as like creating like a lineage of the horses. So every time we see a foal, we want to find out who the mother is and start to create kind of a database of all of the families. And their social structure. So that's kind of one part of it. And then the other part is the fecal samples, which is all the bacteria and parasites. So that's a little bit more information on the project that I am working with. Like, it's less than a week now until we go, which is pretty sad, although it's still too dry for the plane to land. So we're hoping that it's supposed to rain Saturday or Sunday and Monday. We were supposed to leave on Monday, but if it rains that much on Sunday and Monday, we might be able to leave Tuesday. The beach will be harder, although there was a bit of talk about taking a helicopter back, which would be super, super cool. So fingers crossed that we don't get that much rain, and that way we can take a helicopter. That would be really cool. Anywho, I'll be sitting here for a while longer, and I'll probably catch up with you later today sometime. To grab some muffins from the storeroom, so I thought I'd show you guys what it looks like. This is our pantry here, and then Parks Canada has all of the stuff down there. We have this one little section, so I need my muffin mix because I want to make muffins for tomorrow morning. I'm out at the ponds in section 2, so a bit on the westerly side of the island, but I'll show you who I'm watching right now. Take all of your wasted honor. Take all of your so-called problems, better put them in quotations. Say what you need to say. 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 Hello. I am walking towards my next band. I thought I'd tell you guys there was a meteor shower yesterday, and so we went out when it was dark to watch any shooting stars, and oh my god, the sky was so cool, like with no lights around, like the stars were gorgeous, and we saw tons of shooting stars, so that was really cool. Working around the pond area, listening to Jack Johnson, because I feel like that's just the right mood for a lazy, foggy morning. Anywho, I am on a search for another band of horses. Fighting with the shadows in your head. Living out the same old moment. Knowing you'd be better off instead. If you could only say what you need to say. Say what you need to say. Say what you need to say. Good morning! Out in the field again. I think this is day 13 of field work. However, we've been here for 15 days. Gone by so quickly, it doesn't seem like it's been already 2 weeks. My plan is still to leave on Monday. We are getting much less rain than expected. Today we are deciding if we might be taking a helicopter or not. Very exciting. I've never been in a helicopter, and I would really love to be in a helicopter. I think that would be really cool. Anywho, this is our third last day of field work. So tomorrow and the next day we'll still come out in the field and do surveys. And then after that, we have a couple days of cleaning up the house, putting all the samples away. Anywho, it's a little bit bittersweet. I'm definitely like super exhausted, but definitely not excited to leave this place. I am listening to more Jack Johnson today. Another foggy, sleepy morning. We got out a little bit later today, so that was kind of nice. Today I am cooking for everybody else for supper this evening. I put my vegan chili in the crock pot this morning. Yeah, I'm just walking around looking for my next band, and I think I just spotted them. It looks like mom, dad, and Foal, so I'm gonna go over and survey them. And I'll see if I can show you them, because they're pretty cute. Hey,
have no fear for giving in. Have no fear for giving over. You better know that in the end, it's better to say too much than never to say what you need.
Up my day in the field. It was a little bit quieter today, which is nice. When we get back home, we'll probably do a couple hours of lab work. And then I got to see if my chili worked in the slow cooker. Fingers crossed. Day 14, I believe, of field work. I am just coming up on a band of two with one very cute looking chestnut horse, and I can also hear the seals, like they're like really howling and stuff. So I'm gonna try to get a video, and hopefully you can hear it on the video, because they're like growling and slashing and howling. It's very funny. Anyway. I don't know if you can hear them, but the seals are making a ton of noise right now. They're howling. I gotta say, as much as these hills take the life out of me, walking up these hills, once you get up here, the view is pretty gorgeous. To my extremely cool watch, I am 102 feet above sea level. What better place to have your lunch than on the top of a cliff looking over the Sable Island beach? Nothing better than that. That's
where I was having my lunch up there. I have one very brave seal coming up to see what I'm all about. All his friends are very scared.
Good morning. This would have been day 15 of field work. It would have been our last day of field work, however. Our team leaders have been nice enough to let us go out on our own and explore the island for our last day outside, which is awesome. So I'm not actually 100% sure what we're going to do. We might go to the very tip of the island. I think we might go hang out at the ponds for a bit. Anyway, so today's going to be a little bit different. So this is our last day kind of going out and exploring. Tomorrow we're doing a lot of cleaning and getting the house all tidy. Then Monday we leave, and exciting news, by helicopter. I'm so excited. Got a right. It is our second last day before we go. We're doing a lot of packing today. Probably won't get any videos of that because I think that would be fairly boring. Tomorrow we leave on the helicopter at 1. We may go to the beach today. That's probably everything that I'll videotape today, but then helicopter tomorrow, so that'll be exciting. Stay on the island, and I'm all packed up. Everything's all together. My room's all emptied out. Nothing there anymore. Anyway, very sad. We're taking the helicopter out at 1. There's not much to do until the helicopter arrives, but I'll definitely get some video when the helicopter does arrive.
Outside when you're ready, think not the shots and confetti. I'll take you home if you let me. Yeah. Just promise you won't forget me. No, 'cause it is better when you're here. So I gotta keep you near. Going crazy, and I just can't get you out of my.
hope you enjoyed Sable Island Part 2 and the rest of my vlogs this summer. I know I had a lot of fun making them. So hopefully this won't be goodbye, and I will see you again when I do something exciting.